Johnson & Johnson vaccine is a game changer? I'll explain. Johnson & Johnson's COVID-19 vaccine may be behind some of its competitors at only 66% efficacy rate, compared to Pfizer and Moderna's 95%. But once we look deeper, I'll tell you why some doctors are calling this vaccine a total game changer. Plus, how is Johnson & Johnson's vaccine different from Pfizer and Moderna's? And what is it made of? Today, I'm going to go over all of that and more. Hey everyone, I'm Dr. Jordan Wagner. I'm an emergency room doctor who treats everything from COVID to gunshot wounds, burns, you name it. I've created this video series to help answer your questions and the questions I get from patients each and every day like you. If you find this video helpful, please hit that subscribe button so you're notified when I post new videos. Today, we're talking about Johnson & Johnson's COVID-19 vaccine. The company is moving forward with positive results and expects to seek emergency use authorization from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration in the coming weeks, from the time that I'm making this video. So how is the Johnson & Johnson COVID-19 vaccine different, and how does it work? Their vaccine is being studied as a one-dose shot. Yes, that is right, a single dose, whereas Pfizer and Moderna's COVID-19 vaccine, on the other hand, are administered in two doses that use mRNA technology. Also, this vaccine can be stored in a conventional refrigerator as opposed to the deep freeze, colder type storage temperatures that the other vaccines require. This could be a game changer for the medical community. Another way this vaccine is different, well, the Johnson & Johnson version of the vaccine is an experimental viral vector vaccine. This means that it uses a weakened live pathogen as a delivery method for transporting a vaccine to protect against COVID-19. The vector virus here, the adenovirus, delivers a specific piece of COVID-19 to our cells to make an immune response against it. Or in other words, this vaccine uses a small piece of genetic material from the COVID-19 virus to trigger an immune response. However, this genetic material for COVID-19 does not replicate in our body. This is often referred to as a recombinant vaccine. Recombinant vaccines are common, and the science behind recombinant vaccines have been around for a long time. Interestingly enough, although this science has been around forever, it's only been commercially available in rabies vaccines for animals. Adenovirus-based vaccines, like the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, may also pose some problems in that the adenovirus is so common that the vaccine may not be as effective once booster doses are given, or that some people may already have immunity to the virus used in the vaccine. How effective is their COVID-19 vaccine? Johnson & Johnson announced that its single-dose vaccine was 66 to 72% effective at preventing moderate to severe disease from COVID-19, and 85% effective at preventing severe disease. This effectiveness in the phase 3 trial was reached at 28 days after vaccination. So why would anyone even opt for the Johnson & Johnson vaccine? Well, most people may opt for it for two reasons. The number one reason is it's what's available, and any vaccine is better than no vaccine, in my opinion. Number two, some people prefer the single dose option. Despite the lower efficacy, one thing all of these vaccines have in common is they will keep you protected from dying or even going to the hospital because of COVID-19 complications. Does the vaccine have any side effects? Initial safety information released for the vaccine shows that the most common reactions after the vaccine was administered included injection site pain, fatigue, headache, and muscle aches. Additional information on the side effects will likely be included when the final trial report is published. Pushing out the third vaccine quickly might save lives? Yes, but only if people are willing to take it. Herd immunity remains the ultimate goal for the country to go back to normal, which means getting as many vaccines to the public as possible. We shouldn't jump to any false conclusions about getting any one vaccine over the other. If we get enough vaccines in the arms of people, we'll all be better protected overall.
Period.
All right, that's been a quick Johnson & Johnson vaccine breakdown with me, Dr. Wagner. Have you gotten your COVID vaccine? If you're able to, that is. What was your experience like? Did you get the Pfizer or the Moderna vaccine? Did you have any side effects? Comment below. I'd love to hear about your experience. Or If you want to see me get my two doses of the Pfizer vaccine, I'll link to that as well. And are there any other COVID-19 topics you'd like to see me make a video about? Please leave me a comment below. And make sure you subscribe and turn your bell notifications on. When you do that and you hit the like button, you let YouTube know that you'd like to see more videos like this one. Thank you so much for watching and stay healthy, my friends.